champs at the state finals is presented by Lawrence Technological University, where Blue Devils dare. Also brought to you by the Michigan High School Athletic Association, promoting the value and values of educational athletics. And Hungry Howie's, famous for flavor.
Welcome to the 2019 Upper Peninsula MHSAA Girls and Boys Cross Country Championships. I'm Lauren Plant, and we're presented by Lawrence Technological University. Hey, if you want to keep running at the college level, do it for Lawrence Tech. Small class sizes, 24 sports teams, including men's and women's cross country, and now track and field. Check it all out at ltuathletics.com. Scholarships are available. The UP cross country final saw some great performances. The girls, for example, had an amazing group of seniors coming in. Here's Jake Durant.
It was a beautiful day for the UP High School cross country finals at Gentz's Homestead Golf Course in Chocolate Township. We'll begin with the Division I girls race. Marquette looking for their fifth D1 championship in 7 years. The favorite runner heading into this one, Nagani's Emily Papour, looking for her third straight title, and she did not disappoint. Here she is keeping a strong pace as she heads up the hill at the 2 mile mark. All the way to the finish line, she is your D1 individual champion, clocking in at 19 minutes and 18.7 seconds. Kingsford's Melanie Wenzel places second, followed by Houghton's Ingrid Segrin. But it's Marquette who will take home the Division I team title. They edge Kingsford 66-69. Let's move on to the Division II girls finals. Hancock, the reigning D2 champions, they look strong once again, led by their freshman phenom, Maylee Kilpala. At the 2 mile mark, Munising's freshman Hattie Cota would lead, but Kilpala would be right on her heels. At the finish line, it's Kilpala crossing first as the individual champion with a time of 21 minutes and 16.9 seconds. She was one of four Bulldogs to finish in the top nine. Munising's freshman Cota is second with a time of 21 minutes and 43.5 seconds. Ishpeming sophomore Taylor Longtime places third. But it's Hancock who is named the D2 champions with 34 points, followed by St. Ignace with 56 and Ishpeming with 84. Moving now to the Division III girls race, Chassel looking for their third straight D3 championship at the 1 mile mark. Mid-Peninsula looking strong. Junior Daisy England in the lead, followed by teammate Landry Koski in second, with Cedarville's Liliana Kaysen third. At the 2 mile mark, Koski now has taken the lead with England second and Kaysen third. At the finish line, it's going to be Koski getting her first win of her career. Why not do it at the finals? She's the individual champion, clocking in at 21 minutes, 31.2 seconds, followed by Cedarville's Kaysen in mid-Penn's England will finish third. Chassel was crowned champions for the third straight year. The Panthers, who grabbed four of the top eight places for 36 points, were followed by mid-Penn with 73 and Cedarville with 90.
Congratulations to Marquette, Hancock, and Chassel, all really great programs. After this short commercial break, to appreciate the sponsors of this show, it's the boys' turn to take center stage, and we were primed for an historic finish. Stay with us.
I'm on the Blue Devil football team, and that's a great place to be because other colleges wouldn't let me be both a football player and a nursing student. And just because I'm a dog on the field doesn't mean I can't take care of people. And man, do I love people. The small class sizes at LTU give me awesome access to my nursing professors. Lawrence Tech, where Blue Devils dare.
There's an old saying, you can never have too many officials. The age of the average official is 52 and getting older all the time. We're constantly recruiting new people, younger people to join us. After you register with the MHSAA, look on the website to find an officials association near you. They'll put you in a position to succeed as an official. We all learned a lot from high school sports, and officiating is a great way to give back to the game. There's help wanted, just whistle.
Touchdown,
you do know you want a contest to spend the whole day with me, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you just want to sit here and eat this delicious pizza?
We could do other things.
A little help?
That was the best day ever!
Some people will do anything for flavor. Now get a meal deal to fit any budget at the home of Flavored Trust.
Hungry?
Howie!
We now go to the Division I boys finals. A lot of strong runners in this one. At the half mile mark, you can see that the field is pretty stacked still. but the pack is led by Houghton's Joe Wood. At the 2-mile mark, it's Wood separating from the rest of the field. The next closest runner to him is Gladstone sophomore Giovanni Matthews. At the finish line, it's Wood crossing first with a personal best, 16 minutes, 57.8 seconds as the individual champion, followed by Gladstone sophomore Matthews and Sault Ste. Marie junior Jaron Wima. Marquette copped its first title in 5 years with 51 points, followed by Sault Ste. Marie with 57, and Houghton coming in third with 63 points. Moving now to the Division II boys finals race, Ishpeming your reigning champions, and they would be locked in once again at the mile mark. Two Hematites setting the pace, it's Jonah Broberg leading, with teammate Jordan Longtime second, and Adam Cavagnetto of Norway third. At the 2-mile mark, Broberg still leading. His 2-mile time was 11 minutes and 7.4 seconds. Cavagnetto less than a second behind the pace. Longtime a few seconds back in third at the finish line. It will be Broberg with a time of 17 minutes, 29.5 seconds. Second is Norway's Cavagnetto with 17 minutes, 33 seconds. Third would be Longtime. Ishpeming retained its D2 championship with 27 points, followed by Ironwood with 51 and Gogibic with 67. And we'll finish things up with the boys' D3 finals race at the mile mark. It's Brimley's Austin Plotkin with the lead, running the first mile in just 5 minutes and 33 seconds. Thomas Bond of Cedarville right behind him with several runners fighting for the third position. At the 2-mile mark, it's Plotkin and Bond neck and neck. Plotkin would clock in at 11 minutes 13 seconds, Bond just a second behind him. At the finish line, it's Plotkin clocking in at 17 minutes 20.7 seconds. He's the individual champion. Rudyard was crowned the D3 team champion for the first time in a decade with 72 points, followed by Dollar Bay with 93 and Brimley with 96.
Congratulations to all of this year's Upper Peninsula Cross Country champions. Austin Plotkin, mad props to you, my man. Fourth individual crown in a row, only the second guy to do so. And thank you so much for watching this year's coverage. Props to Jake Durant for all of his work. And if you enjoyed the show, please like it and please share it. Thanks for watching.
State Champs at the State Finals is presented by Lawrence Technological University, where Blue Devils dare. Also brought to you by the Michigan High School Athletic Association, promoting the value and values of educational athletics. And Hungry Howie's, famous for flavor.